बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर रहीम महर। टुडे आवर टॉपिक ऑफ टीबीएम इज द रोल ऑफ नेफ्रोमेट्री स्कोर्स इन द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ रीनल ट्यूमर्स। ओके, दीज आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। नंबर वन, टू डिस्क्राइब द डिफरेंट रीनल ट्यूमर स्कोरिंग सिस्टम्स। नंबर टू, टू इलस्ट्रेट हाउ रीनल मैसेज आर इवेल्युएटेड एंड मेजर्ड। नंबर थ्री, टू रिव्यू द मेन वैलिडेशंस इन an attempt to assess relationships between these scores and perioperative and postoperative variables. Okay, introduction. Incidence of renal cell carcinoma rising, incidental detection due to advanced imaging, small renal masses greater than one-third cases. It is widely divergent but oncologically equivalent treatment options like open laparoscopic nephrectomy to robotic partial nephrectomy to percutaneous ablation. Radical nephrectomy, higher rates of chronic kidney disease and adverse sequelae, partial nephrectomy, technical skills, post-op complications, ablation, feasibility and recurrence. Patients largely present without symptoms and the guiding principle of primum non nocere is especially critical in this space. Primum non nocere is a Latin phrase that means first do no harm. Why we needed nephrometry score for different tumor, for different surgeons, for risk quantification, and also for predict surgical complexity, and also risk of perioperative complications and oncologic outcomes, and also communication between treating physicians and comparisons of published studies. Size matters. Tumor size, prognostic indicator for oncological and surgical outcomes, risk factor for urinary fistula formation and post-operative renal failure after partial nephrectomy. This single most common variable with most important complication for overall prognosis. Background. Today, treatment decision making for a given renal mass remains overly subjective because of provider and patient biases, precluding meaningful comparisons between studies due to the lack of standardized and quantifiable tumor descriptors. The score systems currently represent the most comprehensive tools for categorizing patients undergoing surgery into low, moderate, and high complexity based on tumor characteristics. Three main anatomy classification and scoring systems are used. Number one, renal. Number two, PADUA, preoperative aspects and dimensions used for an anatomical. Number three, C-index. Renal and PADUA scores involve similar components and methodology, enabling a comprehensive description of the tumor size, polarity, location, and closeness to the collecting system. While the C-index score involves a complex mathematical concept and characterizes tumor centrally based on the ratio of the distance between the tumor and kidney center, and also the tumor radius. Renal nephrometry scoring system. The renal nephrometry scoring system was proposed by Kutikov and Uzo. The renal nephrometry scoring system was to develop categorized renal masses into low, intermediate and high complexity based on cross-sectional imaging findings. Its purpose to aid in decision making, patient counseling, surgical planning and patient follow-up as well as academic reporting. Classification scoring is based on five basic radiological features of the mass. This score was originally developed for renal masses based on multi-detector computed tomography features utilizing a CT-IVU protocol, but can also be calculated from MRI features. Scoring. Renal is actually an easy to remember acronym. For example, mnemonic of the five features scored as follows. R-E-N-A-L, R for radius, E for exophytic or endophytic, N for nearness, A for anterior, and L for location. The renal score characterizes tumor using size, depth, location, and nearness to the renal sinus and collecting system. Except for the component A describing anterior versus posterior location, a three-point scoring scale is used adding up to the score sum, ranging from a minimum of 4 to a maximum of 12. When to use and why? Patient with renal mass on cross-sectional imaging, CT or MRI, It standardizes reporting of renal tumor size, depth, and location. It also informs surgical decision making and effectively compares meshes in practice and in the literature. It allows for accurate communication regarding complexity of meshes, for example, when consulting with specialists before images are sent. It is validated to predict likelihood of surgical complications, perioperative clinical outcomes, high-grade pathology, and case selection, like partial versus radical nephrectomy. The most consistently used and extensively validated score in the urologic literature. Pearls and pitfalls of the renal nephrometry score. The renal nephrometry score was developed as a standardized system to objectify reporting of critical anatomical features of a renal mass. It provides a quantifiable and reproducible method to classify renal masses according to anatomic complexity. It stratifies masses into low, medium, and high complexity, with increasing complexity correlating with more aggressive tumor biology and more challenging resectability via nephron sparing surgery and clinical outcomes. It can be used in preoperative evaluation, planning, and standardized literature reporting. It doesn't engender specific management strategies. It also doesn't preclude the need to view imaging directly in surgical planning and prior to operation. Okay, we discuss here radius. The radius component represents the maximum diameter of mass in any single plane. Axial images and alternative views, coronal or sagittal, should also be evaluated when deriving this value. The radius is quantitated on a 3-point scale. Figure 1 shows if tumors are 4 cm, we assign 1 point. And those tumors greater than 4 cm but less than 7 cm, we assign 2 points. And those tumors that are 7 cm, we assign 3 points. And tip for radius, it assesses coronal and sagittal views, not just axial. Here, exophytic or endophytic. The exophytic or endophytic component describes the tumor relationship to the surface of the kidney. The exophytic or endophytic status is quantitated on a 3-point scale. Tumors that are 50% or more exophytic, we assign 1 point. Tumors that are less than 50% exophytic, we assign 2 points. While those that are entirely endophytic, we assign 3 points. Lesions that project more than 50% outside the renal cortex are assigned 1 point. Those less than 50%, we assign 2 points. And those that are entirely endophytic, we assign 3 points.
Can you go back?
Okay.
So the more the points, the better?
More the points. More the points, the complexity will be more. I mean, the whole concept of nephrometry score is to, first of all, decide what is the language in which we speak and understand.
Mm.
For instance, if you ask somebody from radiology side that what is the definition of any mass in a kidney, they will tell you that it is like 4 into 4 into 4 centimeter, located at the upper pole, maybe close to the hilum or on the posterior surface. Now, by that, we don't understand what is the actual configuration of the tumor. How much it is exophytic, how much it is endophytic, how close or near to the hilum it is. So, this is something which is like digitalization of a language. So the whole process of nephrometry score, and there are two or three different nephrometry scores. Every score has got its own merits and demerits. But again, it is an attempt to digitalize something which is a figure.
Because it says, while those, the second paragraph, last line, while those that are entirely endophytic are assigned 3 points.
Yes.
So I always thought if it's endophytic, if it's inside, it's a better, should be a better prognostic score, right? That's not the case.
That's not the case because according to complexity, it would be difficult to dissect. If you want to do something like a partial nephrectomy, it would be difficult to dissect something which is endophytic as compared to exophytic. No matter how big it is always very easy to just dissect it out, scoop it out, and do a partial.
Okay. Sorry, I've interrupted.
Broken line shows expected renal contour used to determine E exophytic or endophytic attribute. Tumor projects more than 50% outside renal cortex and should be assigned E score of 1. And tip for exophytic or endophytic, it's not all masses are symmetrical. Use the most predominant feature in any axis. Measure from where normal parenchymal edge should be if no tumor were present. Masses often distort normal renal parenchymal contour. It compares distance from the normal parenchymal edge location, most endophytic and most exophytic portion of the tumors. Nearness. Nearness component describes the distance between the tumor deepest portion and closest sinus, fat or collecting system. Here also tumors again are divided into three categories. If tumors are 7 mm or greater from the collecting system or renal sinus, we assign 1 point. And those tumors greater than 4 mm, but less than 7 mm, we assign 2 points. And tumors that invade, touch or come within 4 mm of the sinus or collecting system, we assign 3 points. The proximity to the collecting system is best determined on excretory image. And the tip for nearness, measure from deepest portion of the tumor in any plane to renal sinus or collecting system. Therefore, anterior, a descriptor designates whether the tumor is anterior or posterior relative to the kidney, midline plane on the axial image. The A by P descriptor is designated using a non-numerical suffix. If the tumor lies primarily on the ventral surface of the kidney, the anterior A descriptor is assigned. Tumors located on the dorsal renal surface are assigned a posterior designation. The A by P by X suffix is used at the end of the nephrometrisum. For instance, a 7A tumor denotes a nephrometrisum of 7 in an anterior location. This tumor is centrally located. Suffix X is assigned to tumor if anterior or posterior designation is not possible. And it assesses in axial view, draw a line paralleling renal hilar structures bisecting the kidney, assign A if primarily anterior to line, P if primarily posterior, assign X if mass on the tip of polar or otherwise cannot be assigned A or P designation, apply as a suffix, for instance 10A. Location descriptor defines the position of the tumor with respect to the polar lines. The polar line is designated as the plane of the kidney above or below, which the medial lip of the parenchyma is interrupted by the renal sinus fat, vessels or the collecting system. Location is best conceived as identifying the tumor position in the coronal plane, although this component is easily assessed on axial imaging as well. Above the upper or below the polar line on axial cuts, a concentric rim enclosed circle of renal parenchyma exists. Between the polar lines, the complete circle of renal parenchyma opens up like a horseshoe and is interrupted by fat, renal vessels and our collecting system as they enter the hilar centers. This is the table of renal nephrometry score. R for radius, maximal diameter in centimeter. If those tumors less than or equal to 4 cm, we assign 1 point. Those tumors that are greater than 4 cm but less than 7 cm, we assign 2 points. If those tumors that are greater than 7 cm or equal to 7 cm, here assign 3 points. Exophytic or endophytic properties, those tumors that are greater than or equal to 50%, assign 1 point. And those tumors that are less than 50%, assign 2 points. While those tumors that are entirely endophytic, we assign 3 points. And for nearness of the tumor to the collecting system or sinus millimeter, those tumors that are greater than or equal to 7 mm, here assign 1 point. If those tumors that are greater than 4 millimeter but less than 7 millimeter, they're assigned 2 points. And those tumors that are less than or equal to 4, we assign 3 points. If for anterior or posterior, no points given, mass assigned a descriptor of A, P or X, anterior, posterior or X, suffix. L for location relative to the polar lines, entirely above the upper or below the lower polar line, we assign here 1 point. And those tumors that are lesion crosses polar lines, we assign 2 points. And those tumors that are greater than 50% of mass is across polar line, or mass crosses the axial renal midline, or mass is entirely between the polar lines, we assign 3 points. The complexity of the renal score is low 4 to 6, medium 7 to 9, and high 10 to 12. This figure shows renal nephrometry score with the scoring of location component, polar lines, solid lines and axial midline broken line are depicted on each sagittal view of the kidney. Number 1 to 3 represents point attributed to each category of tumor.
Can we go back? Can you, Dr. Sir, on a regular CT scans, I know this is a picture, diagrammatic picture, but on a CT scan, actual scans, can we get these features approximately to the collecting system and the sinuses?
There are two ways of... There are two ways of going about this process. One is, if you have got this score and the radiologist is with you, then this can be put into the actual computer software. And the computer can always give you a better score because it can rotate the figure. And whenever you have got a picture, it is always a two-dimensional picture on a film. But if you sit on a console, you have got the advantage of rotating it in different directions, probably in X, Y, and Z directions. So you can have a three-dimensional volumetric analysis as well as something called digitalization of complexity. So, for instance, if you see this picture as such, you can always have an idea what kind of a tumor it is, but in two dimensions. One is the x-axis, the other is y-axis. But the z-axis is always missing in front of you. For that, you have to rotate it. Now, you can do it in two films. For instance, one you take from the anterior surface and the second one from the posterior surface of the same tumor. You got to have the knowledge of what is the kind of tumor covering the posterior aspect. Maybe it is slightly less on the anterior and more on the posterior. But then again, you have to have got two images in your mind just to calculate all these dimensions. But for a computer and the software, if it is built in, and that can easily be done, and I have talked about it with our radiologists, but they are not with the system. They are not with the kind of progress that has been made in oncology, for instance, in surgical oncology. This is the kind of language that we use these days whenever we want to talk between two surgeons. For instance, if I happen to be the primary surgeon and I want to refer this case to another one, then I have to tell him what is my thinking. Maybe I'm not thinking in terms of doing partial nephrectomy. Then he, the other person can ask me, why do you not think that this is something which is difficult as partial? I can tell him that there is a very high score, there's a high morbidity, I have to do a lot of adjustments, for instance. I have to take a lot of blood in my storage because the person will need per-operative blood transfusion and things like that. For instance, if it is going very near to the hilum, then there are chances of losing a lot of kidney because of hilar injury. Now, whenever we talk about something called preemptive analysis of what will happen if I just go in as a surgeon, I will always talk about in abstract terms. Now, from transition from abstractness to something which is as solid as a figure, like for instance a score, it's always easy. it's always easy for this stage of surgery. For instance, we are moving from open surgery towards laparoscopic surgery, from laparoscopic to robotic surgery, which is advanced laparoscopy. Whenever you want to do advanced laparoscopy, you've got to have these kind of calculations, because the next level after robotic surgery would be virtual reality, and then the robot will do on its own. Now, how that robot will have got that kind of information? It will be always in digital format of something which is abstract in terms of writing. So this is a transition. These scores are transition of information being put into a machine so that the machine can do on its own. So this is a philosophical sort of thinking.
Advanced classification.
Yes, it's a visual thinking maybe for a lot of us that we live in augmented reality platform, we work in augmented reality, we enhance our visual capacity by putting in by sitting on a console on a robot, and we enhance our tactile capability by means of something which is endorist, and these are the instruments which are going into the body when you sit on a robot. Now, when you want to minus yourself as a surgeon from console, then again the robot has got an autonomy, and that autonomy will always be when you put in something like a digital format of complex anatomy. Otherwise, the robot will not be able to do anything.
Right. Bedwell classification, preoperative aspects and dimensions used for an anatomical. Padua score of renal tumors takes into consideration five anatomical aspects of tumor plus its maximal diameter. This classification differs from renal nephrometry scoring system, with the main differences represented by the definition of the sinus lines and the evaluation of the anatomical relationship between the tumor and the collecting system or renal sinus. The Padua classification adds another parameter, the tumor relationship with the lateral or the medial rim. All the other parameters like radius and exophytic or endophytic are similar in two classifications. Sinus line. To define the longitudinal location on CT images, the renal sinus is used as the topographical landmark to subdivide the kidney into upper, middle and lower parts. The renal sinus appears in the CT images as a hypodense area, the adipose tissue of the renal sinus inside the renal parenchyma. The upper part of the kidney extends from the upper extremity to the first CT image in which the renal hypodense sinus appears. The middle part of the kidney corresponds to the extent of the renal sinus. The lower part of the kidney extends from the first CT image in which the renal hypodense sinus disappears to the lower extremity. The sinus is an easily recognizable landmark on CT axial examination, but it can also be traced on coronal images or MRI examination. According to the longitudinal location, the tumors are classified into two different categories. Entirely above the upper or below the lower sinus line or across the sinus line, tumors that are less than 50%, here assigned 1 point, crosses the sinus line, tumors that are greater than 50% are falling entirely between the sinus line, here assigned 2 points. Lateral or medial limb. Again, tumors are classified into different categories as being located at the lateral or at the medial limb. Tumors near the lateral rim are assigned 1 point. Tumors near the medial limb, here assigned 2 points. The renal sinus is a central spacious cavity formed by the extension of the perinephric space into the deep recess located at the medial border of the kidney. The renal sinus is surrounded by the kidney parenchyma laterally and almost filled by the renal pelvis and vessels, with the remaining space being filled by fat. On CT images, the low attenuation fat outlines the collecting system and the blood vessels and differentiates the renal sinus from the parenchyma. The tumors are classified into two groups, without renal sinus location, 1 point assigned, and located or at extended level of the renal sinus, assign 2 points. Collecting system, the major or minor galaxies of the collecting system are located within the renal sinus. Tumors are classified into two categories with respect to the collecting system. Absent a relationship, 1 point given. Present a relationship like involving dislocation or infiltration of the collecting system, 2 points given. This is the table of PADUA score. A score assigned to each anatomic feature included in the preoperative aspects and dimensions used for an anatomical classification. Longitudinal polar location. If tumor superior or inferior polar location, assign 1 score. And middle polar location, here assign 2 score. Exophytic rate, tumors that are greater than or equal to 50%, we assign 1 score. And those tumors that are less than 50%, we assign 2 points. And those tumors that are entirely endophytic, we assign 3 points. Renal rim. If tumors near the lateral rim, we assign 1 point. And if tumors near the medial rim, we assign 2 points. Renal sinus. If tumors not involved in renal sinus, assign 1 point. And if tumors involved in renal sinus, we assign 2 points. Urinary collecting system, not involved, assign 1 score. Or dislocated or infiltrated, assign 2 score. Tumor size, if tumors that are less than or equal to 4, assign 1 score. If tumors in between 4.1 to 7 cm, we assign 2 points. If tumors greater than 7 cm, we assign 3 points. Anterior or posterior face can be indicated with a letter A or B descriptor following the score. PADUA versus renal. Polar versus renal. Polar lines, location where the medial most portion of the renal parenchyma is interrupted by renal sinus, fat, vessels or collecting system. Sinus line on CT or MRI by the appearance of the adipose, hypodense tissue inside renal parenchyma. Number 2, inclusion of renal sinus involvement is a separate parameter. This is the figure A, longitudinal classification of the tumors. And figure B, margin location of the tumors. Figure C, tumor relationship with renal sinus. Figure D shows tumor relationships with urinary collecting system. Figure E, tumor shows depending into parenchyma. Figure F, tumor size classification. C index. C index is based on the ratio of the distance between the tumor center and kidney center and also tumor radius. The C index is a method to measure tumor centrality. A key concept is that any tumor with a C index of less than 1 has some portion of the tumor superimposed on the kidney center. And a C index of 1 equals to a tumor with its edge lying on the center. As the centrality index increases, the tumor periphery becomes more distant from the kidney center. This measurement can be made in a straightforward manner using standardized two-dimensional CT images. To measure the C index, a middle plane is identified by averaging image section number showing most upper and lower kidney borders. At this middle section, kidney center is placed in the center of ellipse drawn around the kidney periphery. This figure showing the most upper and lower kidney borders, the last section where kidney tissue is visualized. Image numbers from these border sections are averaged to provide the middle image section number. Right kidney, upper limit in section 78 and lower limit in section 140. We calculate an average of 109. At this middle section, 109 kidney center is placed on the center of ellipse drawn around kidney periphery. Distance Y in centimeter is the number of sections scrolled up and down between the middle section and the section showing the maximum tumor diameter divided by image slice thickness. Distance x in centimeter is measured between the hilar axial reference point and the tumor center. To perform this step, the cursor is stabilized on the central axial reference point during scrolling. Tumor diameter is measured parallel to line draw to measure X. Diameter is half to determine the tumor radius. The image section showing the largest tumor diameter is then identified. The number of sections required to transverse between the middle section and the section showing maximum tumor diameter is recorded, 4 sections, and divided by image slice thickness. In this case, 2 mm to calculate distance y in centimeter. The C index is calculated with measurements obtained from a 2D CT scan to determine the length of two sides of a right triangle. The Pythagorean theorem is used to calculate hypotenuse of the triangle. The hypotenuse is indicative of the proximity of the center of the lesion to the center of the kidney. This number is divided by the radius of the tumor to obtain the C index. Distance x in centimeter is measured between the hilar axial reference point and the tumor center. To perform this step, the cursor is stabilized on the central axial reference point during scrolling. We measure tumor diameter parallel to line draw between the hilar reference point and tumor center and recorded it. Diameter is half to determine the tumor radius. The ratio C by R allow the calculation of the C index. C index model. Figure A to D. In C index model, C shows green lines is hypotenuse of triangle formed by sides X, and Y shows blue lines. C index is calculated by dividing C by R, red lines. Figure A, C index is 0. Figure B, C index is 1. And figure C, C index is 2. While the figure D shows C index is 1.7. DAP score, diameter axial polar nephrometry. It is the integration and optimization of the renal and centrality index scoring system, diameter scoring. If tumor that are less than 2.4 cm, assign 1 score. If tumors in between 2.4 to 4.4 cm, we assign 2 points. If those tumors that are greater than 4.4 cm, we assign 3 score. Axial diameter, axial distance scoring. If tumors that are greater than 1.5 cm, here assign 1 score. If tumors that are less than or equal to 1.5 cm, we assign 2 score. If tumors overlap, we assign 3 score. Polar distance scoring. If tumors that are greater than 2 cm, we assign 1 score. If tumors that are less than or equal to 2 cm, we assign 2 score. If tumors that are overlap, we assign 3 score. DAP nephrometry scoring. Combined ARP scores indicate tumor location and centrality. 1.7 cm tumor, 2.1 cm from axial reference point, and two image sections 0.6 cm superior to equatorial plane is scored as 1 plus 1 plus 2 is equal to 4. Tumor 5.8 cm overlapping axial reference point and in equatorial plane is scored 3 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 9. Tumors that are 3.5 cm overlapping axial reference point and image sections 2.1 cm superior to equatorial plane is scored as 2 plus 3 plus 1 is equal to 6. DAP versus renal. DAP better than renal for warm ischemic time and estimated blood loss. Both scores do not predict loss of renal function. DAP scores greater than 7, we do open partial nephrectomy. Zonal nephro score. This is the table of zonal nephro score based on 3 zones. N for nearness, P for physical zones, R for radius, O for organization. If masses touches the cortex and lower pole below the collecting system and radius less than 2.5 cm and tumors that are greater than 50% exophytic, we assign 1 point. If masses touches the medulla or lateral to but not touching the collecting system and the radius greater than or equal to 2.5 cm but less than 4 cm in diameter, and tumors that are 50% endophytic or 75% Endophytic, we assign 2 points. If mass touches the connecting system or crosses the renal sinus and upper pole or touches the connecting system and radius greater than or equal to 4 cm in diameter and tumors that are 75% endophytic, we assign 3 points. The low risk is 4 to 6 points and the intermediate risk is 7 to 9 points and high risk is 10 to 12 points. Identical small renal masses is scored using individual components of the renal nephrometry score system and the zonal nephro scoring system. The score of the renal is a 7A and the score of the zonal nephro scoring system is 11. ABC score, arterial base complexity scoring system. It is the surgical complexity assessment system based on the arterial vascular anatomy of the kidney. It depends on the size and importance of the arteries to be controlled. This figure shows tumor involving only the renal cortex, thus encompassing interlobular and arcuate arteries. And this figure shows tumor originating from or extending to the renal medulla and reaching the line connecting the tip of the renal papilla, therefore requiring transection of the interlobar arteries. And this figure shows renal masses extending into the renal sinus towards the central connecting system and involving the segmental arteries and their branches. And this figure shows tumor in proximity of or involving the renal hilum. MAP score, MAP, myo-adhesive probability score. It is an accurate image-based scoring system to predict adherent perinephric fat in partial nephrectomy. It is the method of determining perinephric fat measurement. P for posterior, it is a modality used in MAP score, and L for lateral, RV for renal vein. Grading of perinephric staining. Figure A, 0 point. The fat around the kidney demonstrated no staining. On this is computed tomography image. The tissue surrounding the kidney is completely black, while the figure B, mild or moderate. 2 points, the fat around the kidney has some image dense staining present but no thick bars of inflammation. Figure C, severe staining, type 2, 3 points, image shows severe staining around the kidney with thick image, the dense bars of inflammation. High MAP score were more likely to be associated with the male, older, higher BMI and larger tumors. High MAP score 4 to 5 were more likely to progress than low MAP scores and higher complexity of the surgery. Roscoe score, risk of surgical complication score. It includes either the values from the PEDOA or the renal nephrometry scores and combines them with the Charlson comorbidity index and BMI. It is the study prospectively reclassified 320 tumors operated in two institutions according to the PEDOA classification and the renal score. Patients were classified into low, moderate and high complexity groups. An algorithm that incorporated the PEDOA renal score, BMI and CCI was created. The resulting score was then named risk of surgical complication score with an overall complication rate of 26.6. The Roscoe was an independent predictor of surgical complication and performed better than PEDOA, 68 versus 64%, and the renal score 68 versus 60%. Advice: consider competitive risk of morbidity and mortality, oncologic prognosis and patient preference to inform decision making and to risk stratify management strategies. Relationship between these scores and perioperative and postoperative variables. To date, nephrometry has been shown to associate with technique selection, operative ischemic duration, complication rates, and postoperative functional outcomes. It also have verified the relative ease of use and reproducibility of the renal score system. And the management of small renal masses, management strategies typically include surgical interventions, like partial nephrectomy, minimally invasive surgery versus open surgery, and radical nephrectomy like MIS versus open, and ablative intervention, cryoablation, radiofrequency ablation, active surveillance, surgical treatment decision making, impact of renal score on surgical decision making, partial nephrectomy versus radical nephrectomy. Higher complexity score more likely to undergo radical nephrectomy. Minimally invasive surgery versus open, high complexity scores more likely to undergo open surgical approaches.
I think we should stop here and just summarize the whole talk. Right. So please. Thank you very much. So you see, this topic is maybe informative for someone, maybe may not be so informative for others, but it is important in the sense that we all have to learn some language whenever we want to speak up, whenever we want to communicate between each other. When we are committed to something called renal tumor, then you will be able to see a lot of complexities. And the complexity will not only be in terms of bilaterality of the tumor, but it can also be a multifocality within one kidney. When you want to do, for instance, the kidney is like 10 centimeter in longest diameter, and there are two tumors, one sitting at the upper pole, the other one sitting at the lower pole. It might be possible that they are in the range of less than 4 centimeters. So you might think that I can do two partial nephrectomies and I will be able to save a lot of nephrons in between the upper pole and the lower pole, and the kidney can function properly. But then you have to satisfy a lot of things. You have to satisfy that whatever amount of volume that you want to reject out, the amount of volume that you just leave behind is sufficient enough to withstand everything in terms of GFR. That goes with volumetric analysis. Again, you have to satisfy yourself as a surgeon that if you want to take one root, chopping off one pole at one time, and maybe after 15 minutes the other pole, both the things can go into the direction of some vessel or not. Meaning to say, if there are interlobar vessels in front of you, maybe there are awkward vessels which are coming up into your view. One way of going about your life is to just go into the situation, and as a hero, you can face anything in the world. So it's like Jason and the Argonauts. No problem. I can face any ghost, any monster, because I am capable of fighting with my sword. So that is not the way the world is moving. The world is moving with pre-planning, something called predictability, something which can be replicated. We are all equal. There are no people who are having green fingers, the other one brown fingers. We all have green fingers. In order to make everybody sufficient, proficient, efficient, we need something which is mathematical. We need something which is predictable. We need something which is like models, predictable models, or predicting models. So this is the world of modulation. We modulate anything called, our weather pattern. We modulate diseases like we do in COVID-19 case pandemic. We also need to have these kind of models into practice in our daily routine, pre-operative planning of our surgeries. Otherwise, we'll be having a lot of mess, and that mess will not be taken as such by the countries which are actually in the process, and they are ahead of us. They are actually implementing it. And there is another thing which is attached to it, and that is related to human rights. Now, a person who has got a tumor is giving him or her to you to just operate, never asking any question. Whether you know how to do it or not, he or she is just going about your persona, for instance. But the world has moved to a point where every surgeon, every physician has to tell the person in front of him or her plainly and sincerely that this is the kind of complexity, these are the kind of problems that we will face during your surgery, these are the kind of success rates that can be predicted on the basis of these kind of models. There is no score, mind you, which is perfect. Every score has got some merits, some demerits. For instance, renal score. Renal score has been studied in more details. It has been a topic for many, many years. You will find a lot of articles on renal score as compared to the other scores. But the problem with renal score is it is not taking into consideration anything which is like a thrombus in renal vein, for instance, or IVC. So the renal score is not something which is something which is a definitive, the final word. No score is a final word. But whenever you want to go from one paradigm to the other paradigm, you have to think a lot. You have to have a lot of options so that you can pick and choose. And you should have your own thinking why you are picking this score for your institution, for your unit, because it is giving you maybe 90% of information that is being needed, so that you got to have maybe close to 100% results with your partial nephrectomies or radical nephrectomies. So thank you very much.
Okay. There would be some tumors which would be black and white, and there would be some tumors which will be in the gray zones. So the most important point in defining these scores would be how to tackle that gray area. So from your surgical perspective, how would you go about dealing those gray areas, and what would be the most important thing that you would look forward to from a surgical perspective?
First of all, you have to tell me the definition of gray area. Gray in from the angle of identity of a tumor?
Certain would require a complete nephrectomy or a total nephrectomy, and some would require partial nephrectomy. But there is in between area. I mean, if it is the score lies in the middle, moderate intensity, then you either can go either ways. You can go for a total or you can go for a partial as well.
Right.
So your decision primarily will be based on what perspective?
You see, if you go towards TNM classification, there is again a vague TNM classification. We always have this kind of notion that anything which is less than 4 cm is something which you can put into the basket of small renal masses. You can put that person into a separate clinic. You just do, for instance, a 6-monthly scan just to know what is the growth pattern of that tumor. So that is active surveillance. You can do a biopsy of that tumor, because 20% of them might be oncocytoma and things like that, maybe benign in nature. For them, you don't need any surgery. But you see, 4 cm is something which is just one digit. What we need to know is something which is the volume. I mean, everybody has got a kidney which is like that person's surface area denoted by the palm or the fist. Now, a kidney size is vaguely it is like the fist size. So everybody has got its own fist size, meaning to say it is the volume which is important rather than a single digit length of breadth or the depth. So you see, there are many fallacies. If you take into consideration anything like TNM classification, we all have been trained and we all have been practicing TNM classification just to put ourselves into one group or the other group, maybe partial, maybe complete. It is the volume which is important. It is the GFR which is important. For instance, if you have got an 11 centimeter tumor and there is a 6 centimeter mass which is all in all 90% exophytic, your hand will be itching that I can just take it out without any comorbidity, less blood being transfused during surgery, less amount of bleeding, and it can easily be taken out because it is not close to the renal collecting system, it is not close to the renal hilum, it is not close to any major vessel. So if there is any awkward vessel, I can just do some stitching. So these are the plannings, but that planning has to be on the basis of a three-dimensional picture, on the basis of volumetric analysis, on the basis of something which can be easily talked about. Now 4 centimeters is something which is very vague. So we are progressing. The thing is, the beauty of all these scores is we are progressing. At least we have put ourselves into the thinking process. Maybe the next generation of surgeons, and these are the next generation in front of us, they will be using it more appropriately, more properly than we are. But the thing is, you have to satisfy yourself that this is a language that has to be learned. If you don't learn it, nobody would take you seriously that you are doing something, whether partial, whether radical, no matter. But you have to tell the person that you are doing it something objectively.
Whenever we hope for a partial effectomy, we take a consent for radical effectomy because we are not sure what's going to happen for operatively. And safety of the patient is very important, and we explain the patient about the complexity of the matter, that this can be done and this can be done, and there can be recurrence as well and everything. We had a patient who had a solitary kidney, and he had a 16 centimeter exophytic mass at the upper pole. On a follow-up, he was a taxi driver and he wanted a partial effectomy rather than a radical effectomy. And he said that I cannot afford to go on a dialysis because of my condition. So we explained him the whole procedure. We tried to perform a partial effectomy. At that time, we were not calculating these poles, but now we have started doing it. So we explained him everything and we went for operatively. We removed that 16 centimeter exophytic mass, which was at the upper pole, less endophytic, more exophytic, and a successful surgery was done, and he had a fistula and urine was leaking for like about 2 months, 3 months, and we kept him on DJ replacement. At times we thought that we have to remove this kidney. We discussed with the patient and we kept on lingering, carrying on that, and now that patient became okay and there was no urine leakage from that. So after decision making, you have to take your patient in confidence. You have to explain him everything. You have to make sure that the patient becomes safe. And while discussing about the decision making, whenever you are taking a decision, you have to think that I am the primary surgeon and I am over there operating this patient. How will I go about it? Then only you can make a good decision, rather than just see that 4 centimeter, okay, I'll do a partial effect. So, you have to think in a larger perspective.
Right. Well said. Thank you very much.